Hi, I'm Jag from the team at Slack. Let's talk about lists. Lists bring work management to where you and your team are already collaborating, in Slack. In this video, I'll show you three simple ways to use lists in Slack: to manage a project, to collect requests, and to plan work with your team. Let's dive in. Manage projects and collaborate on them where you're already working. Turn conversations about action items, due dates, and project resources into trackable work with an easy-to-use list. To get started, navigate to Lists and click New List. Customize the list by editing and adding fields such as Task, Status, and Due Date. When you're ready, add items to it. You can also add items from Slack messages in just a few clicks. As you add items to the list, assign priorities and owners to them. Keep your list organized however you choose by sorting and filtering it. For example, sort by due date and filter by priority to see which tasks to tackle first. Save views you want to come back to and easily switch between them whenever you need. Then, share your list in a channel or give specific teammates access so they can see the views you've created, create their own views, and add or edit items. And whenever you and your team want to discuss a specific task, start a message thread on an item so the conversation stays in one place. Subscribe to items to keep tabs on the progress. Notifications for items you've subscribed to will appear in the same place as all your other Slack notifications, in your activity feed. Try using lists in Slack to manage your next project. Collect and triage requests in a list, right in Slack, where everyone who needs to see them can. Say you collect IT help desk requests from people across your company in one tool, but collaborate on them in another. Your teammates may lose visibility into the progress of their request. Simplify the process by managing and triaging requests in a list. Navigate to Lists and choose a template to get started. The Help Requests template is a useful starting point. Relevant fields are built into the template, but you can edit or add more depending on the information you're collecting from your requests. Next, set up a form to collect your colleagues' requests. Each list field becomes a form question, and when your colleagues submit the form, the request will be added to your list. To get notified of each new submission, set up an alert in the Help Desk channel. When you're done, bookmark the form to a channel, such as the channel dedicated to help requests, for easy access. Let's see what this looks like. A colleague opens the form and submits a request, so you get notified in the Help Desk channel. Open the list to see all the requests, and change the layout to visualize them the way you need. Grouping requests by status in board layout is a useful way to glance at requests and their progress. Review the new request and assign it to someone on your team to take action. If you need to discuss the request, start a message thread right in the list item. This is a great way to communicate with the person who submitted the request. You can read and reply to message threads on list items in the same place as all your other Slack threads. Try using lists in Slack to simplify a request collection process at your company. You can also use lists to collect feedback and keep a backlog of ideas organized. Plan work using lists that you can share and discuss with your teammates where you're already working, in Slack. Let's say you've started planning for the next quarter, but your team's ideas and goals are scattered across channels, docs, and spreadsheets. Create a straightforward catalog of planned work using a list. Navigate to Lists to choose a template to get started. This quarterly planning template feels right. Relevant fields are built into the list for you, but you can customize as needed by editing them or adding more. Next, start adding items to your list. Or you can turn any message into a list item with a few clicks. This makes it easy to add project ideas to a list right from the brainstorming conversation you're having in a channel. To share the list with others, click the Share button. Teammates with access can add to the list or edit the data in it. You can also share the list with a channel so everyone in the channel has access to it. This is useful so your entire team or anyone else you share the list with can collaborate on it. Whenever you want to discuss planned project ideas, start a message thread in a list so the conversation stays in one place. This is a great way to align on and prioritize list items without losing context. There you have it, lists right in Slack. Use lists to keep track of tasks that you've got on the go stay aligned with your teammates in the flow of your conversations, and save time on work with less switching between apps. To learn more, check out our other videos about lists or search lists in Slack's Help Center. Thanks for watching!